It's the sixth leading cause of death in the country, and it's known as the caregiver's disease. One in three seniors are diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease. But as you're about to see, Rhode Islanders much younger are living with Alzheimer's, and there is no cure. Mike Montecalvo has more.
Just to know what it was.
It was a diagnosis of Alzheimer's. Jake Friend has been living with the disease for about 10 years.
I used to love driving.
Now only 57, everyday things are slipping away.
I was just saddened that I had of the things that I used to know how to do very, very, very well that I just can't do now because I've lost the intellectual capacity for it.
Jake's wife, Karen, knows it's going to be a challenging road.
The uncertainty of what the trajectory of what the illness is going to look like, you know, sort of day to day, week to week, is difficult.
We went looking for answers, and according to the National Alzheimer's Association, more than 5 million Americans have been diagnosed, 25,000 in Rhode Island alone. By 2050, that number is expected to triple, and the cost of caring for patients in the U.S. this year, $200 billion, and there's no cure in sight.
It's a terminal illness, and gradually people lose functioning, and they lose recognition of family members in the later stages, and that's a difficult process. The family members end up really mourning the loss of the person that they loved while the person is still alive.
Have you already planned for down the road of what he might not remember? He might not remember your name?
I've thought about that, but I don't think that I'm emotionally ready for when that happens. So I think that one will be difficult.
Jake knows the curve life has thrown his way, and he's ready to accept it.
It's going to be a slow degradation with all the medications that are now available. That's okay. But sometime down the road, it's just not going to stop. And when that time comes, I hope I will go gracefully.
And here this morning to tell us more about the Alzheimer's Association is WPRI's Mike Montecalvo, along with Donna McGowan, executive director of the organization. Mike, to see that story, it takes your breath away, and then you also see the bravery he has of knowing that this is his future.
You know, he just meeting him and talking to Jake and his wife, he's an inspiration because he doesn't want to give up. You know, he was in his 40s when he was diagnosed with Alzheimer's. He's only 57 now, but he's physically fit. He walks, he goes to the movies, he goes out to dinner with his wife. So he has not stopped, but he knows what's going to happen down the line.
And this is very close and dear to your heart, too, because your family has experienced this.
Yeah, my mom was in her 60s when she was diagnosed. She passed away over 6 years ago at 76. And, you know, Will, you go through stages. You go through disbelief, mm-hmm. you know, or you don't want to accept it. Then you go through anger, why does it happen? And then you go through a fatigue process after, like you accept it, but it's like you're always tired because you never know what to do. And I think that's part of the problem with Alzheimer's is families just try to do it all by themselves. And trust me, I've been there. Eventually, you can't do it anymore by yourself.
Right, and that's where organizations like yours, Donna, comes into play. And there is help for families. We hear about the patient all the time, who's the person suffering, but the family members, they may not have a place to turn to, and that's where you can help.
Absolutely. We have services. First of all of our services are free to the constituents and the families and friends in the state of Rhode Island. We have a 24/7 helpline where you can call in at any time of day to get help and consultations. We provide care consultations. We do education and training to the caregiver, the family, friends, employers, employees, professionals. We are able to give CE credits to the professionals as well. We have support groups all around the state of Rhode Island. It could be husband and wife, it could be grandparent and child, but they're all over the state of Rhode Island, going off every day as I speak and in the evening. We do advocacy work. We advocate on the local, the state, the regional and the national level to change the laws and increase budgets to provide the services we need to provide to our families who are affected by this dreaded disease. And we have our best program, which is our early stage social engagement program, which is used to be the Live and Learn program. It's been in existence for about 6 or 7 years now.
Right.
We've grown to 5 sites. You have to have a diagnosis of mild cognitive impairment, and it's free. You come in, they meet a whole group of new friends, they have social activities and exercise, brain-enhancing exercises, and it gives the caregiver some respite time, some time off.
And then this wouldn't be able to happen without, you know, the organization. They're having a walk, and that's where the money comes from to help your organization, to help people who really need it. Mike, tell us about the walk.
Well, it's this Sunday at Slater Park in Pawtucket. It starts at 9. By the way, it's supposed to be absolutely beautiful. So the Eyewitness News...
He's not guaranteeing that.
Tony told me it was going to be. Okay. So sign up is at 8. The walk is at 9 o'clock. You know, we do a lot of walks. They're all fun. This one here is neat because you see, as you can see, people walking from last year. You know, families get together, you know, to remember a loved one who passed away or a loved one who might be living with Alzheimer's. We've even seen, you know, pets come along,
pets
too.
Pets are welcome. So. As long as they're on a leash, they're welcome. They come in their purple T-shirts.
Whatever works
it's
to get everybody out
amazing.
There.
It's simply
out there and raise the money.
Well,
thanks both for coming in. It is a powerful story. The walk to end Alzheimer's is this Sunday. And as Mike said, weather's going to be beautiful. September 29th, Slater Park in Pawtucket. And it begins at 9 a.m. WPRI is a proud sponsor of the event. And for more details, just go to WPRI.com.